Good evening and welcome to SPF ETV's presentation of Raider Wrestling 89. I'm Tony Chihuahua with Glenn Gato, and tonight we get to see the Scotch Plains Fanwood Raiders as they battle the Union Farmers. Glenn, what record do both teams have as of today?
Union is currently 6-1-1, and Scotch Plains is currently 1-6.
All right, and those are your records. They're the Raiders. They're being announced right now. Andy Brown being announced.
At 130 pounds for Union, Rick Hardman. Scotch Plains, Brian Roglin.
There's Brian Roglin.
135 pounds for Union, Dominic Popoff. For Scotch Plains, Mike King. £140 for Union, Mike Francesca. Scotch Plains will forfeit. 145 pounds, Steve Lely for Union, and Bruce Sergio for Scotch Plains.
And those are the participants in tonight's battle. We should have a good matchup, especially in the heavyweight division.
Yes, Plack is a very good wrestler. Said he can compete with Ferroni of last year.
One upsetting note, Mark Seck will not be wrestling tonight. Had a freak accident, hurt his knee. Raiders very unfortunate this year with injuries.
Very injury prone this year, you could say.
Four broken wrists, hurt wrists, hands, two knee injuries, Zach out, and of course you, Glenn.
And Fass is out with a hyperextended shoulder. He should be returning soon. There's the captains, Rick Zimbardo for Union and Lily for Union, Mike Martin for Scotch Plains and Steve Shirello for Scotch Plains.
There's Coach Zanowitz and the Raiders, a record of 1-6 so far. We're just about underway for our first matchup here tonight.
103, they're going to, Scotch Plains is forfeiting, and 108 as usual.
Another forfeit.
Scott Rosander is going to be coming up against Earl Finney.
We're just about underway for our first matchup here.
Union wrestler shoots, gets in on a single, trips him, gets his two. He's working for hand control. Looking for a bulldog tilt. He's trying to put Rosander on his back. Scott's got to look where he is right now, try to get out of bounds, get a clean start. They're working. They go out of bounds. Go back to the middle.
2-0. Earl Finney leads over Scott Rosander early on, 1:24 left in his first period.
Scott's got to move, work the first move. Tries to stand. Sit out. Rose looking for that tilt again.
Fitting on top.
This guy's got to try to work to his base. He's got that hand. He's got to work. He's got to get up. He's going to get hit with a stalling caution. The ref's counting right now.
Finney has him packaged up quite well.
He's trying to put Roseanne here on his back. This guy's gonna try to stay in that position, try to get a stalemate, or try to get out. Can't give up back points. Was trying to get a cradle, trying to get a bone arrow cradle. He's got it locked, stacks
10 seconds
it.
Left.
This guy can't get on his back now. Can't get on his back. Two. That's the end of the first period. Gets two back points. That brings the score to 4-0.
Union leads early on here.
Roseander defers his decision to Union. Union wrestler will take the defensive position. Scott Roseander gets on top. Working near waist far ankle, and they go out of bounds. Scott's got to work his moves right off the whistle. Union wrestler stands, Roseander tries to trip. Union wrestler turns in and gets his 1 point neutral.
4-0, Finley over Scott Roseander. That's 5-0 now.
Scott's got to shoot first. Union wrestler shot first twice. Scott's got to shoot. Union wrestler shoots. Roseander sprawls, and the Union wrestler comes around for his 2 points. Scott's trying to get his wrist free. Trying to get some moves for his break. Sits out. The wrestler stays behind him.
Now 7-0, Finney over Scott Roseander.
Union wrestler's looking for that tilt again. Scott's got to get his hands free. Tries to stand. Scott's trying to work to his base. Roseander's getting on a bulldog tilt right here. Hasn't given up back points yet. The ref counts. He's getting awarded his back points.
Almost out of bounds there.
Scott's got to get out, and they're out. We're back to the middle for a clean start.
Finney throws Roseander as they're getting up.
Scores now 10-0, Union wrestler in the lead with 15 seconds left in the second period. Scott sits out. Trying to work up, stands, Union wrestler takes him back down.
1 second left.
Tries to switch, time runs out in the second period.
Well, Glenn, Roseander's in a big hole here. No points on the board for him. He's got to come out looking for something, preferably a pin.
He's going to start off at the offensive position. He's got to work, try to get his back points, try to get back into this. Union wrestler sits out, stands, is peeling, turns in, gets his one. Roseander has him on his back, gets his two takedown.
Can't get him up, can't get him over on his back.
Ref hasn't awarded the takedown. They go to the neutral position. Good wrestling by Scott Rosander shows he's not giving up. Scott shoots, Union wrestler sprawls. Union wrestler has Rosander's leg. And he hits him with a throw. No back points are being awarded. 2 points takedown are being awarded.
There's just over a minute left in this final period.
Back points are being counted out.
In Earl Finney's last match against Linden, he won, he pinned Jason Stanko in that last match. Union winning 54-20. And now he's got Rosander almost on his back.
Rosander's fighting off his back as much as he can with 40 seconds left in this third period. And he reverses him. Reverses him and loses by technical fall. I don't think they awarded Rosander his one point. And then he got. And that call stands. I guess Rosander didn't get that 1 point neutral. Wins by technical fall. Brings the score to 16-0. Or 17-0, sorry.
Rosander not even getting on the board. Our next matchup, James Dupree will take on Andy Brown. There's Andy Brown on your left, Dupree on the right.
Brown ties up.
Trying to lock up here.
The wrestler shoots. Hits a headlock. Brown gets out of it. Circles behind him. The wrestler has a whizzer in. Brown can't be wrestling sloppy now. He had him. All he had to do was back trip and he's wrestling sloppy. He's got to settle down and work for his takedown. Shoots in. Had the leg. Union wrestler spins around him and gets his two.
In Brown. Andy Brown's last match, Scotch Plains against Elizabeth, Brown was pinned against Ronald Menhavar.
Brown's
but
sitting
out. Tough early on.
Working from the bottom. Union wrestler's got a 2-on-1. He's got both wrists tied up, looking for the half. Brown sits out. Brown got the leg.
They go out of bounds. Dupree leads 2-0.
Brown's got to get up. 52 seconds left. He's got to get some points on the board.
Union on top. 17-0 here early on.
Brown sits out. Looking for the Peterson. Gets two. Reversal. Takes him down to the mat. Now he's got to work for tilts, something to put him on his back.
Ref calls him out of bounds.
Union wrestler gets his 1 point neutral. That brings the score to 3-2. Brown losing.
30 seconds remaining.
Work for a takedown. Try to work in the middle of the mat. The ref likes it when you work inside the circle. Tie up. Brown looking for control. He's got to shoot. Brown's got to shoot first, do the first move.
Thirteen seconds left in his first period. James Dupree on top of Andy Brown, 3-2.
Brown's got to shoot. He's wasting too much time looking in. Trying to get tie up. It's the end of the first period. Brown trailing 3-2. Brown takes the defensive position.
Well, Glenn Brown stuck with him in that first period. Close score, 2-3. What do you think he might have to do here?
He's got to try to take the lead. The Union wrestler's going to have the choice in the third period. He's got to try to get up here, get some points. Brown sits out. He's got to keep on working. He's working. Just keep on sitting out, trying to get his points. Brown trying to get his wrist free. It's working. He's at his base. Sits out. He's got the lead.
Nice take.
And he gets his one neutral. That brings the score tied 3-3. The minute 21 left in the second period.
Just over a minute left in this second period.
Brown hasn't shot yet. He's got a shooter. He's going to get hit with a stalling call or a takedown. They go back to neutral after the Union wrestler takes him down out of bounds. Brown shoots in, has a double leg, gets his...
Nice.
Ref hasn't awarded any... Brown gets his 2 points takedown. That brings the score to 5-3, Brown. He's got to stay pumped here. Don't give up any points.
23 left.
Try to get his back points.
5-3, Andy Brown now leads.
Brown looking for the arm control. It's working. Union wrestler stands, turns, gets his 1 point neutral. Brings the score to 5-4. Brown still leading. He's got to go after him just like he did before. Get his takedown, shoot in good on double leg. Get his two. He's backing up now. He can't back up. He's going to get hit with the stalling. Brown shoots in, the Union wrestler throws him and gets his 2 points.
30 seconds remaining here.
They go out of bounds with 29 seconds left.
Union leads 17-0.
Brown's got to get up here, 29 seconds left. Second period, he's got to look for a lead. Sits out. He's got to jump over there. He's got him. Union wrestler's weight is too far in the front. He should tripod up, get the Union wrestler off balance, get his points. Union wrestler throws in legs. Looking for a power half. Three, two, one. Period ends. Score at the end of 2-6-5, Union leading.
Well, Glenn, we got a seesaw battle here. Third period here will determine.
Union wrestler takes the defensive position. Brown's got to keep him down. Sits out, turns. Brown stays with him. Got to trip him, try to get him down.
Nice. Brown grabs his left leg.
Union wrestler hits him with the drop.
Uh-oh, look out.
He's got Brown on his back.
Brown has to push off.
And he gets out. Union wrestler gets 3 near fall. That brings the score to 11-5, Brown trailing.
He's got him in that tilt.
He's got him in a nice move. Brown gets pinned with a minute 15 left in the third period. Brings the score 23-0, Raiders trailing.
It was a good match, very close until the end.
Brown got sloppy, he tried moves he shouldn't have really tried. Got sloppy with his moves, that's why he lost. Brian Roglin's coming up next.
He'll face Rich Hardman. In the 130 weight class.
Hardman, a very tall, lanky wrestler.
Yeah. underway.
Union wrestler shoots in for one. Looking for his takedown.
Hardman has Rogan wrapped up nicely.
Takes him down for two. Rogan trying to get a hand control. Union wrestler trying to tilt him, put him on his back. Gets awarded his back points.
Rogan using his legs to try to get out. Now Archie's up.
Union wrestler throws a cradle. Rogan sits through it. They go out of bounds. Rogan trailing 4-0. Rogan's got to explode here, try to get some points. He's got to try to get to his base, get his wrist free.
Union Farmers on top, 23-0. 1 minute left in this first period between Brian Rogan and Rich Hardman.
Union wrestler has a bulldog tilt here. Getting awarded his back points. Brings the score to 7-0. They go out of bounds, going to the center for a clean start.
7-0 now, Hardman leads.
Rogan sits out, the Union wrestler takes his arm, brings him back down to the mat, looking for a half. He's got the half, trying to tilt it. He's got an arm bar in there. Ref calls timeout, Rogan's headgear covering his eyes.
I noticed there the ref called time because of his headgear came off, but some refs evidently don't. They let them wrestle on. Is that up to them?
It seemed like the match wasn't going favorable each way. Rogan couldn't see. He decided to just break the match, go back into the position in the middle. Union wrestler throwing in a leg. Rodman's got to kick that leg out of there. He can't leave it in there.
Match is not going favorable for Rogan as he's trailing 7-0 with 5 seconds remaining in this first period. And first period is over.
Rogan trailing 7-0. Brian Rogan takes the defensive position. Rogan sits out. Union wrestler has his wrists. He's looking for a switch, but the Union wrestler steps over. Union wrestler has got a thigh pry in. Trying to get wrist control. Got him in a cradle. Rogan's fighting. Rogan gets out. Union wrestler gets 3 back points. That brings the score 10-0.
Some wrapped up in a package, you might say. 10-0 now, Hardman.
Union wrestler's got a leg in there. Rogan's got to get that leg out of there. He's got to mule kick it out of there. Union wrestler throws a cradle. Getting awarded his back points. That'll bring the score to 13-0.
40 seconds now remaining. Second period. Rogan definitely has to pull something out of his sleeve here.
Union wrestler gets awarded his 3 points. near fall, breaks the move, throws another cradle. Rodman breaks it. And the wrestler locks it up again.
5 seconds now left in the second period. 2-1.
And the wrestler.
The score after two periods, Rich Hardman leads 13-0 over Brian Roglin.
Union wrestler takes the defensive position in the third period.
Well, Glenn, pin is the only thing that would look good in Roglin's future here.
Yes, Roglin's got to work now. He's got to work for the pin. Union wrestler switches. Gets his two. No, I don't think the ref awarded him two. Roglin's got control of the leg. Union wrestler got to get his leg free.
Hardman trying to get Roglin onto his back any way he can.
Now the Union wrestler gets awarded 2 points. Union wrestler wins by a score of technical fall, 15-0. Mr. Lilly congratulates as Union wrestler.
28-0. Now your score, Union over Scotch Plains. Mike Kane now comes out onto the mat, goes up against Don Oakley.
Shoots in, double leg takedown, gets his 2 points.
And they're going at it. Fast paced match here early on.
Just working thigh pry. He's got a far half in and a leg.
Aqui working on that right arm.
They go out of bounds.
Kane in a hurry to get started here. 2-0, Don Aqui on top.
Kane's sitting out. Grabs the Union wrestler's head. Gets his 1 point neutral. Union wrestler throws a nice fireman's carry for a 2 point takedown. Scott Roggins left. And he works him over with a half.
Nice, arches his back, almost got pinned there. Mike Kane did.
It was a half, he's got a wrist.
Minute left.
Runs around the head. Kane bridging. And the rest of the figure fours ahead. Potentially dangerous call. Gets 3 back points.
4-1, Aqui over Kane. Now it is 7-1.
Kane's got to work up. Get out from the bottom. Wrestler got his wrist, gets wrist control. Looked like he was looking for a head lever. He's trying to get his control. Kane can't reach back. Shouldn't reach back when you're on your knees.
Kane trying to give all he's got. Trying to get that head locked up with his left arm. But he's just going in circles right now at this point.
Wrestler's got trying to get a half.
His first period
Let's
will come to a close.
Got his one. Union wrestler hits another fireman's carry for two and puts Kane on his back. Kane's got to work here. Time runs out. Union wrestler gets his 3 point near fall. Brings the score to 12-2. Union wrestler takes the neutral position.
Well, Raiders look like they're in trouble here early on. They're underway now in the second period.
Kane shoots in, Union wrestler sprawls. Union wrestler looking for a throw and gets it. Puts Kane on his back. That will end the match as a pin.
Pins him.
Union goes up 34-0. bringing on the biggest match of the night. Lily from Union versus Lucertio from Scotch Plains. Lou's really pumped for this match. This will be an upset if Louie beats him. Louie's a very good wrestler himself. Mr. Lily is very, very good. His dad is the coach. Lou's got to get pumped for this one. This is a big match for him.
Sergio, in his last match against Elizabeth, pinned Barry Bowles, which is a good sign.
Shake hands, start the match. Lou goes in, shoots. Lou's got him behind him. And they go out of bounds, no points were awarded. Good wrestling going on so far. Lily shoots in, Sergio sprawls. Lou in on the single, can't let go of that leg. In on the single leg still, Louie. Louie trying to get his leg free. Lou tries to step over, Louie rolls him through.
No score here early on, 1:20 left in this first period. Steve Louie against Lou Sergio.
Ref calls a stalemate, didn't look like either kid was doing anything there. Louie tries to shrug him, going on the leg. Tying up, Lou's trying to tie up his arm. Drags him. Lily goes through with it. Lou's trying to tie up his arms.
50 seconds now remaining. Score 40-0, Union Farmers over the Raiders. Nice takedown by Lily.
Sergio
no points
tried
awarded.
To get him up. Lily hip-throwed him. Gets his two takedown. No back points were awarded. Lou's got to try to get up. He's got his leg. Lou's trying to stand with that leg. Lily's got his ankle, though, preventing him from standing.
Now it's free.
Lily puts him on his back.
Oh, and time runs out. Sergio was on his back, excuse me.
Gets his 2 points near four. Lou's on the offensive position starting the second period. Lily sits out. Lou's got his wrist. First third of half. Lou's looking for wrist control. Sits out. Looking for his two. Louis steps over. Regains control. No points were awarded.
Four to nothing. Lily over Sergio.
Lily's got Louie on his back with a nice throw.
He's on his back, look out.
Lou's got to work now. He can't give up the pin. There's a
Looks
minute
like
left.
Looks
He's working off his back. Lily's got that locked in tight. Lou's just trying to get a fight off his back for 45 seconds.
He's got to fight him off. He gets
Lily
pinned.
He gets the pin.
Louie Sergio.
Lou went out, gave it his all. Look.
Nice match by Steve Lily right there.
Two good wrestlers going out there. Steve Sciarello's up next. Steve off to a great season. First year varsity exploding. Going out with everything. Steve's a really laid back wrestler. Takes matches one at a time. Doesn't even look for the future.
And Shirillo takes on Rick Zimbardo. Excuse me, that's Rob Vieira.
Rick Zimbardo's going 160. He usually goes 152, but tonight he's going up to 160. Shirillo's tied up. And they go out of bounds. He's got to try to work him in the middle. Try to keep him in the middle of the mat.
46-0, Union leads over the Raiders.
Steve shoots. Union wrestler's got a front headlock in on him. Tries a shrug. Steve shrugs it back. Steve's got to look where he go out of bounds right there. Try to go out of bounds. That's it. Go back to the center for a new start. 1 minute left. Steve's got to shoot. He's tying up. He's trying to get that arm control. Steve drives into him. They go out of bounds again. Steve tying up again.
No score here.
Goes in, keeps on driving, gets his two takedown. Steve's union wrestler tries to switch. Steve's trying to get that left arm tied up.
30 seconds remaining in his first period.
He's looking for a head lever right there. He's got to break him down to his stomach before he tries that move. Watch his weight right there. They go out of bounds. Steve's trying to work him on his back.
7 seconds left here.
Steve's up 2-0. Union wrestler trying to escape and they go out of bounds. First period, Steve Shirillo up 1-0.
Very defensive first period, both wrestlers, Glenn.
I guess Shirillo's a laid-back wrestler. He doesn't wrestle cautious. He wrestles, gets his takedowns when he knows he can get them. Doesn't try anything sloppy. He's in control of himself, very controlled wrestler. Goes for the fireman's, comes up with his 2 points. Just ducked under it when he knew he couldn't get it. Union wrestler trying to switch. Steve counters with double leg. Union wrestler sprawls, gets his one red, and gets the 2 reversal. That brings the score to 4-3. Steve's trying to sit out. I think he was going for the Peterson there. Wrestler's getting wrist control. Steve's got to work up to his base.
Just over a minute left in the second period.
Steve gets to his feet. Peeling gets his 1. Brings the score to 5-3. Steve goes to the center. Union wrestler shoots. Steve sprawls. He's going for that cradle. He's going for that bow and arrow cradle. Union wrestler grabs his leg, prevents him from getting the cradle.
Trying to turn him over.
Steve cross faces. Union wrestler's got his ankle hooked up. Steps over. Union wrestler gets the 2-point takedown. wrestler's got an arm bar in.
Under 10 seconds in this second period. We're tied up 5-5.
The wrestler trying to run around the head with that bar, trying to get Cheryl on his back, but can't. Time runs out in the second period. Goes into the third with tie score, 5-5.
Score 46-0, Union over the Raiders here.
Union's on the defensive position. Cirillo takes offense.
Union Farmers have a very good team this year, 5-1-1.
Yes, they're up with Westfield, who's undefeated as of now.
Yeah.
Two top teams in the county in today's Star Ledger.
Union ranked third behind Roselle Park and Westfield, who both have 5-0 records. Westfield, big win over Plainfield, 60-11 in their last match.
Very good match in that. Gary Palmer versus Povilak. Palmer lost to Povilak last year. Povilak beat Palmer last year. Palmer came back and beat him this year. Palmer's a very good wrestler.
And we're underway.
Courier ranked him one of the top at his weight class at 140. Steve still got control. Score still 5-5. Steve working for his wrist control. Looking for the half. He's got to watch his weight there. Can't get too high up on his head. Steve looking for that half. He's got to watch his weight. He's got to watch his weight right there. The Union wrestler's just got to turn back in. Steve's still going for that half, Nelson. And they go out of bounds. The minute 14 left in the match. Rick Zimbardo warming up, and so is Mark Dambau for the next match. Steve gets on top.
Very tough for the Raiders to come back here. Extremely tough. In fact, they can't do it, it looks like. Steve Cirillo, as you mentioned, very good wrestler.
Steve gives up the one-point takedown, works to the middle of the mat. He's got to get a takedown with 50 seconds left. He's trailing 6-5. He's got to shoot. He's got to shoot before the Union wrestler does. Steve shoots. Union wrestler sprawls. Steve gets behind him. Steve gets his two-point takedown to take the lead, 7-6. He's got to keep control out of him now. He's got an armbar. He's got to watch his weight right there. He's getting his weight too far on his head, on the Union wrestler's head. Working the armbar. Looking for that tilt. He's looking for the tilt.
10 seconds left in this third period. It looks like it'll come down to the wire, Glenn.
He's got to keep hold of those armbars. 2 seconds left. Steve and comes out with a great victory.
The Raiders are now on the board, 46-3. Good, hard-fought defensive match.
Steve wrestled a very good match
there.
Came back.
Rob Vieira also wrestled a good match on the losing side.
Zimbardo's up. Didn't wrestle in the beginning of the year. Didn't even come out for the team. Very good wrestler. Wrestled varsity all 3 years. Senior this year. He's going out against Mark Dambau, sophomore. Zimbardo wrestles freestyle a lot during the summer. Very fast wrestler, very quick wrestler.
Dambau gained a pin in his last match. Pinned Ruben Guevara of Elizabeth.
Zimbardo likes to make little funny remarks with his face when he's wrestling. Distract the other wrestler, get his team laughing, going.
I can do that? Yeah.
Zimbardo goes in for a single, gets his two takedown. like he's going to work a tilt right here. Nice bulldog tilt. Stays on his toes. Trying to work Danbao to his back.
2-0 Zimbardo leads over Danbao. And what? 60 weight class. Go ahead, Glenn.
I'm glad Zimbardo came back. Too good of a wrestler to just stop wrestling in his senior year. Zimbardo's got that arm tied up. Gonna look to put him on his back right here. Throw in the legs. Mark gets his two reversal.
Now it's 2-2. It's ready to lock up. 37 seconds left in this first opening period.
Zimbardo's another wrestler like Shirelli. Doesn't get mad at himself. He just takes things one at a time. Doesn't worry about things. The only thing he cares about is who gets his arm raised at the end of the match.
31 seconds now remaining on the clock. Knotted up at 2 apiece.
Zimbardo standing. Zimbardo looking for a throw. Zimbardo goes in, double leg takedown, takes him down for 2. Danbao's got control of his leg. Danbao's got to try to get to his knees and suck in that leg. End of the first period, Zimbardo up 5-2. Takes the defensive position in the second period.
Union Farmers lead overall 46-3. Very strong Union is. Another surprise is Rahway. They have a good record this year, 5-0.
Last year they were very good. They one of the top in the county last year, as of this year too. We were a very tough county with Roselle Park, Union, Westfield, Elizabeth strong now, Rahway strong.
Summit is strong, 5-0.
Summit, years ago, used to be Scotch Plains, Summit, Westfield, Cranford used to be great.
Yes.
Teams like Elizabeth, Rahway, due to the rec programs that are really good now, established some very good wrestlers. Zimbardo gets 2 takedown there.
We're back underway here. 7-2. Zimbardo leads over Danbao. It's the 160 weight class. 1:35 remaining in the second period. Danbao on the bottom.
Danbao tries
top.
To switch. Gets control of his leg. Zimbardo grabbing his ankle, preventing him to get around his body to get his 2 points. Ref calls a stalemate. Didn't look like the wrestlers were going anyway. Bell starts on defense. Gotta try to get some points on the board. Switches. Zimbardo lets him up for 1. Zimbardo's a very good wrestler from his feet. Like I said, he likes to wrestle freestyle during the summer. Freestyle is all feet wrestling. It's all upper body wrestling.
1:02 left, second period.
Zimbardo shoots in on the double. He's got double underhooks in on Zimbardo. Zimbardo trying to work something here.
He Zimbardo's slipped.
Got a single.
Coach Zana with yelling for Danbao to take the chin.
Zimbardo counters with the throw. Eduardo gets a two. Goes back on offense. Danbaugh trailing 9-3. Stands. Suarez looking for a cradle here. Going, looks like they're going to go out of bounds. Weston Bardo drags him back in.
1 second left in this second period.
Zimbardo on top, winning 9-3. 1 second left. Time runs out. Score 9-3. Zimbardo gets on top. Danbaugh tries to switch, turns in.
Going. Danbaugh pushing his head down.
Zimbardo's got that leg. Ref's going to probably call a stalemate in this position, which he just did. Starting over again.
1 minute, 40 seconds remaining. 9-3, Zimbardo on top of Danbaugh. In this third period, 1:30 left to go.
Zimbardo's got that arm. Looking to put Danbaugh on his back. Mr. Lilly pushing him to push himself. Do the same thing. Danbaugh's trying to work to his base.
Just under a minute left in his final third period. 9-3, Zimbardo leads over Danbaugh.
Zimbardo working thigh pry now and a wrist. Danbaugh standing. Zimbardo countering with an ankle. Trying to get up. Bardo's working to put Danbaugh on his back. 23 seconds left.
Got 15 seconds left.
Bardo working the wrists. Danbaugh trying to get up to his base.
Five seconds remaining.
Go out of bounds. 5 seconds left. One-point neutral award. Sparta lets him up for one. Goes 9-4. Sparta takes the victory.
Score 49-3. Next up is Mike Martin. He'll take on Rob Kuldanek.
Kuldanek isn't a varsity wrestler. He brought him up from JV to wrestle this match. Martin's going to go after him. He needs this win. Sat out two matches because of a disqualification, like Mike Dunlap is right now. Goes in on a single, gets it in good on Martin.
Well, he
Martin.
Tried to get Martin up and over, but couldn't there. Martin stands his ground.
Martin's looking for a throw there, sloppy throw, got put on his back with a headlock. Martin comes out, gets his one neutral. Brings the score to 4-1.
Step out of bounds for a moment.
Martin's got to wrestle smart. He was wrestling sloppy right there. Union wrestler shoots in, Martin Sprouls. Good for a power half. He's got to run around the head right there with that. And they go out of bounds.
-3 your score. Union Farmers over
Martin
Scotch
Martin throws him, nice lateral. Puts him on his back, he's got to move to the head right here. Martin's got to move to the head to get the pin. Union wrestler rolls through, Martin gets his 3 points. Mike's up 6-4, he's got to get in control with himself now. Take it calm, easy. Martin's got wrist control.
30 seconds remaining now. His first opening period. It's Mike Martin on top. That's Rob Kuldanek, my fault. Where I was going to say, Rich Tullis, he takes on Mike Martin's brother in the next match, Brian.
Gets his 1 point neutral. Brings the score to 6-5. Martin's got to get the takedown here. Can't give up any more points or he'll be trailing. Mike's got to work here. Try to get his takedown.
Period comes to a close. 6-5. Mike Martin leads over Kuldanek.
Martin's on the offensive position. Ref tells Martin to get on. Martin working a wrist and an ankle, trying to break the Union wrestler down through his stomach. Throws a half. He's got to crank that right there. Get the Union wrestler on his... Martin's got to get control of himself. He got disqualified last match. Cost him two matches. Can't have that now. Season's coming down to an end. It's only 6 matches left in the season. Mike's trying to get a cradle. Union wrestler, looks like he tried a crawfish. Martin steps over, gives him his one. Neutral.
6-6 tied up here. 1:25 remaining in the second period. 49-3, Farmers on top of the Raiders.
Tie 6-6 here. Martin's got to shoot. Can't be wasted time. Tie up.
Lock up there. Under a minute. The second period.
Martin tries to jack him up. Looking for a headlock. Union wrestler trying to throw him too. This could go either way. Mike pops his head out. Gets around him for two. He's got to get his leg free there. Try to kick it out.
Martin takes the lead 8-6. 30 seconds remaining.
Got a cross face there, go out of bounds. Good match going here. 8-7, the Union wrestler gets his neutral. Union wrestler calls injury time, says his knee hurt, and he did hit it pretty bad. I know how that feels. Jim Slimovich coming out on the mat here, trying to look at his knee.
Well, Glenn, this probably will be the last game up here in the booth. Then we get to watch you in action.
Yeah.
Raiders' upcoming schedule. After this, they'll take on Cranford. And we'll be back after this commercial message. We're back here now. 8 seconds left.
Union wrestler took down Mike Martin for two. Brings the score to 9-8. Union up. 4 seconds left. Martin's got to try to get an escape here, try to get one or something. So got to work. Quick sit out, quick stand up. 4 seconds. He could do it in that much time. Time's gonna run out here. No points awarded. 9-8 going into the third period.
Well, Glenn, when Tullis had that slight injury, and right after that he came back with a quick 2 points, and now he's ahead of Martin, 9-8. As we about ready to start the third period.
Martin gets on top. Union wrestler sitting out, gets his one. Brings the score 10-8. Martin's got to get a takedown here to tie it. Very good match going on here. Martin working, trying to set up. Union wrestler gets in on a single. Martin goes out of bounds with a clean start in the middle. Mike's trying to work here. Get his takedown. Mike works back into the middle of the mat. Union wrestler told not to tie up. I guess they know Mike likes to throw lateral drops, headlocks, a lot of upper body. He's got a power half on him now. Force when he puts him down to the mat. With it, he's got to crank it here, or shrug it, get behind the head, get his 2 points. There's only a minute left. He just gave up a perfect opportunity to get a takedown.
Yes, he did.
He's got to shoot. Martin's wasting too much time. 50 seconds left. If he wants to win this match, he's got to take him down and put him on his back. Union wrestler circles around, he's got a cradle on Martin. Martin's got to break this. Don't give up the two. You're out of bounds. Two was awarded a Union. That brings him 12-8. Martin reverses him, puts him on his back.
He's got him. Oh, he gets out of it.
I think Martin did get three. Therefore, that will bring him to 13-12 and leading this match. 14 seconds left. Martin can't give up any points. Goes out of bounds with 8 seconds left.
Well, Glenn, this one will come to the wire again.
Get in the middle. He's got to get in the middle. Ref will give him the other guy a point. Both kids taking a breather, are pretty much winded.
Very tiring.
Little burst in wrestling gets you tired. A 10-second burst going all you can, that'll get you tired.
Well, this final 7 seconds will seem like an eternity for both wrestlers.
Martin gets on top. He's got to work. Can't give up any points. Gets his one neutral. No points were awarded. Neutral. Time ran out. Brings the score to 13-13 and a tie.
Hard fought match.
Very good match there.
Well, it did come down to the wire. Tullis pulling something out of his hat.
Martin should have won that match. 8 seconds left. All he had to do was break him down.
51-5 is your score.
Mike's brother comes out against another JV wrestler. They're going to go at it here. They lock up. Two strong kids. Looks like two football players out here. 1 point Green against Union. They tie up. Brian trying to push his head out of the way and go under for two.
Brian, a good wrestler for a sophomore.
Union wrestler goes underneath for a duck under. Doesn't get awarded his 2 points yet until he gets his head out, and there he goes. Gets his two.
2-1, your score.
Brian reverses him with a nice Gramby roll. Gets his one neutral. Brian tying up. One point Green again, another illegal misconduct to the face. Another one, Martin gets two. Another one, Union wrestler gets disqualified. Ryan's got to shoot, he's got to watch his legs here.
3-2 your score here. Brian Martin leads.
Martin working an underhook. Union wrestler locking that up. Stalling on both men. Neither men were trying for it. Martin looking for the shot. Gets caught in a throw. Union wrestler goes to a headlock. Martin throws a leg, looking for an ice, it looked like. Union wrestler looks to be wrestling a little sloppy.
Both wrestlers going at it.
It's a very sloppy move by Union. Martin just spun around and got two.
With 5 seconds now remaining in this first period. Your score after one period, Brian Martin leads.
5-2. Union wrestler takes offense. Martin sitting out, getting to his feet. Nice drop. Nice throw by Martin's got the Union wrestler on his back. He's got a lock up, rotate to the head. Watch his weight right there. And reverses Martin to his back. Martin's got a bridge.
.130 left in the second period.
Martin working off his back. Gets off his back.
Nice.
Trying
move.
To reverse him. Gets the Union wrestler in a headlock. Lifting up on that arm. He's got to crank that arm up. Arches back. Sit through like he's doing.
12-7. Martin leads.
Union wrestler looks pretty much pinned right here. He's bridging. He's pinned right there. If the ref would have turned around, he would have saw it. Martin's got to keep control of this. 55 seconds left. Got to lift up on his head. Union looks pretty much pinned right here. Ref's got a better eye than I do.
He gets the pin.
Falls the pin and Martin comes up with it.
Well, Glenn, that goes to prove how impressive Brian Martin is. In his last match against Elizabeth, he pinned John Howard. And now pinning Rich Tullis. That ups the score now, 51-11.
This brings up the big guys, the heavyweights.
And you, that's some understatement heavyweight when you see both these guys out there.
Al Scarpa's a big guy, and compared to the Union wrestler, he looks small.
Scott Platt, the big boy from Union.
Al tries to go in on the leg. Pratt's a very big boy. He's a sophomore.
Sophomore, is he really?
Just wow. That big and a sophomore.
They're
just
getting bigger
like
every
Ferroni.
Day.
Al goes in on the leg. Nice fireman's carry for a takedown.
Two points for Scarpa.
Al's got to work here. Union wrestler stands up, gets his one. Al's working. A little headbutt by the Union wrestler. Not called, though. Called on Mike Martin, but not called on him. Union wrestler's got that underhook. Al's in on that leg. He's got to look for that throw right there. Good wrestling by Al. Doesn't give it up. Union wrestler trying to crank Al over on his back.
Scarpa now close to on his back. There he is. Scott Platt all over him.
I don't know if Al can get out of this one.
It's a 40 big, seconds left, Glenn.
It's a big boy on top of him.
He looks like he might have him.
He's got his arms tied up underneath there.
He gets him.
Gets the pin. Final score, Union 51, Raiders 11.
So now with that pin, final score.
56.
57. 26 seconds left in that first period. Scott Platt pinning Al Scarpa. Your final score, 57-11.
And I'm Glenn Gato.
And I'm Tony Ciolella. Thank you, and good night.
All the way around from first base to third. And the outfield is really where the Raiders have done a lot of damage today. Not the most well-hit ball, but he got decent aluminum on it. And he managed to find a place out there on the grass.
Here's Pat Hamilton, who doubled his last time up. He also flagged to right and struck out. One for three on the
game. Infield is in once again, and Hamilton a shot out to right center. Center fielder has a good jump on it, but it gets by him.
Butzel scored, Dan Bowles scored.
Hamilton, he was held up at second base by Coach Hom, and he has himself a double.
It would have been a close play at third. I kind of surprised that Hom held him up. But there's still nobody out, recall, so no need to take unnecessary risks. Hamilton comes in with his second double of the day and has two more RBIs.
It is now 15-9, and things are starting to get a little ugly here. Dan Bowles seemingly broke the game open here, and now with Hamilton's shot, he's cleared the bases.
The Raiders, remember though, had a 7-2 lead that quickly diminished, and there'll be a new pitcher for the Blue Devils.
I thought the center fielder got a pretty good jump on that ball, just too far out of his reach. So you see Pat Hamilton there, standing there at second base, picking up two big RBIs on that double. He's done a good job for the Raiders, filling the number nine hole. That's good to see with the bottom of the order. Butts with the walk, Dan Bowles with a double, and now Hamilton with a double contributing for your team. It's a big boost for the Raiders. And there'll be a new pitcher in the game, and he'll have to face the top of the order here in sixth. Michaelson. Eight for four. Hamilton works in the stretch. Oops.
Hits that one hard to left field.
And that'll drop extra bases.
Hamilton will cruise on in. Michaelson will hold up at second.
Michaelson. Let's see if he can have a triple. He'll have a little cycle here. About slapping the ball around. That's his fourth hit on the day. A couple singles, a double, home run. Impressive, Eric Michaelson.
While I was getting the pitching change for Westfield, I overheard Mark Dambau saying that he's never hit a ball that far in his life. Dambau with the RBI double into left field.
Slow curveball outside. And you mentioned how depleted the Raider pitching staff is. The Westfield pitching staff is really getting work out today.
He's the fourth pitcher Westfield has used.
I believe so. Kirsch pitched well.
Urchick swings to the right.
It's a benefactor of a few bad errors by the Westfield defense that really hurt him. So Urchick to get a little base hit here and knock in Michaelson.
Fisher still would be the winning pitcher. He was there when the Raiders took the lead. They have looked back.
16-9 game.
Urchick with head 2-1. Inside. 3-1. McDivitt. What was his first batter?
Come on,
second batter. Michaelson was his first.
It's a rip by Urchick. Way foul.
He got around on that one.
Nice liner through the trees over our truck. It's a good little shot there by Virchick.
May have taken out a squirrel or two in the process.
Now 3-2 count, still no one out here. In the sixth.
Eighth batter of the inning for the Raiders.
Divin taking his time, working from the stretch.
Six ones across.